I should consider myself as a responsible citizen on the question of environment. I'm taking care of my footprint when I'm at home. But as soon as I go to the hospital and in the operating room, I have the impression that my behavior is changing and I do not respect all the involvement in sustainability when I'm working in anesthesia. And the second thing is that in several meetings in anesthesia, I've seen sessions on the impact of anesthesia on our planet. We have an impact as anesthesiologists, but also as a healthcare provider. Let's speak about the hospital. We know that the hospital is one of the main polluters. The operating room is the most important polluter of the hospital because of the surgery, because of the anesthesiology we do there. An operating room is 30% of the waste of the hospital, of the entire hospital. And if you consider anesthesia, anesthesia is around 25% of the waste of the operating room. Are we able to recycle? We are using products like plastic, paper, and also all sorts of metal like copper, iron, inox from the blades, for example. We use products that may have a footprint on our planet. There are several papers about halogenated anesthetics. We know that desfluran, sevofluran, isofluran, and the other halogenated are present in the atmosphere. Not the atmosphere of the operating room. We know how to evacuate these gases outside the operating room. But in fact, we evacuate them in the atmosphere. There has been an experiment in Switzerland showing that we can detect these products at the North Pole, at the South Pole, on the top of several mountains. Can we change that? Yes, we can change that by reducing the use of these products, by using scavenging systems to avoid to eliminate these products in the atmosphere. Other examples, the use of nitrous oxide, for example. Can we avoid using nitrous oxide? Do we spill propofol in the sink? We should avoid to do that because it's a huge polluter of the water. So this is the subject. Does it change the quality of the care? I don't think so. By behaving this way, we improve our impact on the planet, but we do not change the quality. Even we can improve the quality of the care by thinking again how we take care of the patients. Yes, I am not myself a regionalist. As long as it is a part of a larger behavior on the operating room, I think that's a good way to avoid to use products that may pollute the atmosphere or pollute our planet. About regional anesthesia, did you consider the life cycle of the material you use? Where do you buy your needles? I'm working in France. I consider that if I need to pick up a needle produced in Germany, for example, or in a very far country like China or Japan or on the other side of the planet, I should consider this point when I purchase the material. And after that, do you recycle your needle? If there is copper or iron or whatever, perhaps it's possible to recycle them. It's not a problem. You need to wash it and to discuss with the responsible from the sterilization. You don't need to sterilize them before sending them in the recycling system. The problem is that sometimes the materials are composite materials, a mix of plastic and paper and iron and metal. So this is more difficult to recycle, but we need to think about that. Several companies have an involvement in the sustainability of their own products. they manage their industries and their companies with this greening ID. And the second thing is that we could also use reusable materials. Also, think about reprocessing of the materials we use. Reprocessing means that we use first and then we send back to the company. They sterilize, they wash and sterilize again the material. They check the quality of the material and then they sell it back. The companies could do that with several of our of the devices we use in anesthesia or in surgery or in healthcare. Very few, in fact, but we should push them to do that.